What's going on, guys? Danny Hacker here with KECO Body Pair Products. In this video, we're going to go over the assembly of the L2E. So we're going to turn this into this. Let's get started. If you ordered the L2E, you should have a total of 5 boxes. One being the tool cart, tools, TabPrint organizer, third panel assembly, and your shop light. But first, we're going to go ahead and start unboxing the cart and assemble that first. Now that we have everything laid out, you'll see that we have a third box that goes to the cart as well. This is going to be our third panel conversion kit. So the brackets that come in the original L2 is actually for the L1 now. So we're going to discard these brackets because in this box here, we'll have an extra longer set for our third panel. So going over some of the hardware. You'll have a bag with the letter L on it. This will be 36 screws. This is what we're going to use to bolt the side panels to the shelves. Next, we'll have a bag with the letter N on it. This will be 12 screws that are a little bit longer than the 36 piece. Okay, keep that in mind because that's what we're going to use to bolt the brackets to the shelves. Next, we'll have a couple bags with self-tapping screws. This is what we're going to use to bolt the brackets to the back panel. Coming down to a bag with the letter P on it. This is what we're going to use to bolt the handles to the side panel, okay? And then last but not least is going to be our carriage bolts. This is what we're going to use to bolt our casters to the bottom shelf. So the first thing I like to do is grab my side panel, go ahead and grab the top shelf. I like to start building the cart laying flat on the ground. Now, when I go to start putting screws into this cart, I want to make sure that I hand snug them. I don't tighten them all the way down until I get every screw into the cart. Once we have all the screws just hand snugged, I didn't tighten them all the way down. Once we have completed that, go ahead and take your cart, turn it upright, and start putting the screws along the back. Now we have all the screws in the cart. Remember, we didn't tighten anything up yet. And we left these back screws out for a reason. We left them out for our brackets. Now that we have our brackets attached, you'll have 4 screws left, okay? You're gonna grab the bag with the letters NN. It'll have 4 washers and 4 nuts. We're going to put the rest of these screws in these remaining bottom holes here. Now that we have all the screws hand snugged into the cart, our next step is to go ahead and start tightening all the screws up. We have all of our screws nice and tight. Now, our next step is going to put the back panel on. So something I forgot to mention before, make sure we're using a number 3 Phillips on the screws that go into the shelves. The screws for the back panel are going to be self-tappers. We recommend a number 2 Phillips for those. Now last but not least is going to be our casters and handles. So I like to build the car sitting like this just to make sure everything is nice and straight when we go to start tightening everything down. Once I've gotten all the screws in place and tightened down, next I'm going to take the car and lay it on its backside. Tip I like to do is placing my knee right under this caster just to kind of hold it up while I insert the cage bolts. Now using a half inch ratchet, we're gonna go ahead and start snugging everything up. Last but not least is gonna be our handles. Now remember, they go on the driving side, so left side of the cart, if we're facing it, that's where your handles are gonna be installed. Tighten up the handle, you're going to need a 9/16. Alright guys, so this is your L2E collision cart assembled. Next we're going to go over the TabPrints organizer, so stay tuned for more. Now on to our next step, and that is installing our TabPrints organizer. One thing we need to keep in mind is the fact that this cutout right here, kind of looks like the Big Dipper, that needs to go to the front. Always make sure that's in the front, all right? This is gonna be our miscellaneous spot for miscellaneous tools. Make sure that is to the front of the cart. Now when installing it, it's gonna kind of typically be like installing a bed liner in a truck. Take the center of it, kind of fold it in, get the edges under the edge of the shelf, and then slightly push in and push it back. Once we got that in place, we want to take these edges, get it pushed down into the shelf, and walk your way down. So as you see, it's sitting in there nice and snug. So make sure that you put this cutout to the front of the cart. Now the fun part. Unboxing all of the tools. Now that we have all of our tabs in their designated location, you'll see why we engineered it and designed it this way. So if you have a big dent, guess what? You're gonna be right here in the roughout section, right? Large damage, large tabs. As we get that damage, you know, starts moving and walking out and gets flatter, guess what? We're gonna move on down into the more smaller tabs, more finishing tabs. So this is gonna help you. It's gonna be kind of like a roadmap to a dent repair, right? Big dent, big tabs. As it gets smaller, guess what? We move on down and finish it out as accurately as possible. We're getting this cart pretty darn close. Our next step is gonna be installing the Z caddy. Z Z-caddy is going to be installed on the right side of the cart. Left side is driving side. Right side is going to be where your Z-caddy is going to be installed. That's going to hold your glue gun, infrared, heat gun, isopropyl, and glue sticks. So when installing the Z-caddy, you want to make sure that we drop down to the second line of holes. Once we have it up on there, when we go to place it, line it up to the holes, make sure there is a slight gap here. This gap is going to allow for the caddy to hook out into the bracket. All right, so once we got that already installed, next step is just to slide the caddy, pop it in, take your glue gun holder right here, boom. Two cups for your glue sticks and for your isopropyl alcohol. And it's that simple to install your Z-caddy. As you can see, we're just about there. So we built our cart, we've installed our TabPrint organizer, all of our tabs are in their designated location, and the Z-caddy has been installed as well. Last thing we need to do is park all of our tools on the back panel. Now your L2E is officially assembled. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and get out there and start pulling some metal.